did, you changed the agenda, you said you had to throw a wrench in my plan.
You can still speak for it.
Thank you, I'll work with that, very generous. Well, it must be quite a week with the no mask situation, isn't that quite a new change? I'm grateful for it, and I know some people hung on to that thing like a hobo on a sandwich. But not me. Just on that change, on that policy that you changed, you didn't bother to say who recommended it. It was a school board member. I understand that has changed because of probably an error. But my suggestion is, please give us the name of the school board member that recommends policy changes, so we have some accountability and we can go back and ask them what's up. So I'm not going to get into that, but I do think it's the direction it was going is not good. I don't like the idea of giving even somebody as admirable as our superintendent a blank check. Let me read from the policy, because the policy is still in existence. The Prince William County School Board believes that public awareness of the policy-making process is highly desirable, and that consideration should be given to the views of teachers, parents, and other concerned citizens in the development and implementation of school division policies. Now, think about that. Think about what we've been through since I've been involved with this board in May last year. I'm not surprised that somebody came up with that idea. We had an incident, or the case of the FOIA request that showed that maybe the chairman wasn't that interested in transparency. Okay. You came up with a plan to reduce the time for people to speak to 2 minutes. That lasted about 1 hour. You have had for a long time now, until tonight, an outrageous seating policy that was based on nothing that I could discern that made any sense. In fact, out of all the seats that the fire marshal said were available, you only allowed the use of 9%.